have a problem with chess websites. Playing online is great, and reviewing games is almost great, but it's missing something. For me, that's in the openings. I've wanted there to be a way to record a list of all the opening moves that I know or have studied, so that when I review or analyze a game, I can immediately be pointed to where I may have forgotten my lines, or when I encounter a move I've never seen before. Now, if you're like me, the only real record of openings that you know is stored right up here, in this hard drive of questionable reliability. Sure, I could write these down or even create a study with all these moves, but even then, needing to look up and compare moves against my games is neither fun nor easy. So I've been building something that I think solves this pretty well. It's called Chess Cloud, and I like to refer to it as an openings builder, but it's also a game server and an analysis tool. I'm going to go through what it is, how to use it, and plans for the future. So let's take a look. Head to chesscloud.com and click Get Started or go to the Openings tab. You'll have a board on the left where you input your moves and a small board on the right where you'll see the beginning of your opening tree. As you input moves into the board on the right, you'll see these moves get added to your tree. Let's switch to Openings for Black where I've already entered some moves. The tree is interactable. You can scroll to zoom in and out, click and drag to move around. And when you hover over a move, you'll see a preview of the board position after that move. Click on a move to jump to it. Right-clicking will give you options for that move, like delete, which will delete that move along with any lines that branch off of it. You can also add comments to describe the ideas of a move. If you're familiar with Markdown, comments also support Markdown formatting if you want to get fancy with it. So let's paste a comment I've prepared for 1e4 and click Save to take a look with all the formatting. The menu in the top left lets you change the size of the preview boards along with the orientation of the tree. Once you've created your tree, you have a couple ways to compare games against it. You can go straight to Analyses and import a PGN, or you can play games right on Chess Cloud. Keep in mind, since this is just being released, the available game pool will be small, so I can't guarantee you'll find a game in the earlier stages of Chess Cloud, but I will be adding the ability to play with friends, so be on the lookout for that. That being said, for this example, let's grab a PGN from chess.com or LeeChess where I may have played a game. And if you don't know how to do that, in LeeChess, you're going to go to a game and you're going to click Analysis Board. From there, you're going to scroll down and click Share and Export. And there you'll find the PGN, which you can either copy and paste or download. From chess.com, you're going to do a similar thing. You're going to go to your game, click on Share, go to PGN, and copy and paste or download the PGN. Let's start with the LeeChess game. We're going to go back to Chess Cloud, paste in that PGN, and click Create. You can also create a custom position by dragging pieces onto the board, but right now, let's just stick with this PGN. Now that we're in the analysis, you can see a few tools here. The classic eval bar, the top engine line suggested by Stockfish 16, and the last thing is Chess Cloud's openings evaluation. This is what enables us to check our openings against the tree we created earlier. If I analyze this game here, we'll see the moves that follow my openings for black highlighted in green. In this game, I encounter 2d5, the Scandinavian defense, which I've never recorded, so it's highlighted in yellow. If I click the green plus sign next to d5, it'll add that move to my openings for white, acknowledging that I've now seen this move and I can go and find a response that I like. Now let's take a look at that other game. We're going to do the same thing, but we're going to grab the game from chess.com. Again, we're going to paste it in and click Create. Now since I played this game as black, we're going to need to click on black to see this game from black's point of view. Here I followed all my prep up until bishop b5, where I responded with f5, the Yanish Gambit. Since I don't actually play f5, it's highlighted in red, showing I may have forgotten my prep. Then in gray, I'm shown the move that's in my prep, which is knight f6, the Berlin. And this is all based on what I've recorded in my personal private opening tree that we created earlier. And that's the main idea with Chess Cloud, a place to easily store and review your opening repertoire. There's a lot in the pipeline, like challenging friends, improving the online game server, and more that I'm really excited to build. Since this is all brand new as of recording and actively being worked on, I'm sure some issues may come up. That being said, please reach out with any issues, ideas, or questions. You can reach me here on YouTube, Twitter, which I'll link below, or send an email to support@chesscloud.com. Thanks for watching.